I'm Karen Adrienne, and I'm the artistic director and one of the founders of Circling the Square Fine Art Press. Jennifer Strode is also a founder and brought the very first press to us. The press began in 2007, and we're an open access press. And what that means is that everyone is keyed and we to the studio. And usually we work in small groups, but since the COVID virus, we work one at a time. People come in, they come in, use the studio, disinfect, and then the next person can use the studio. It has a wonderful history of artists making all sorts of different kinds of work, etchings, linos, lithos, silk screens, monotypes, and all sorts of combinations of prints. We have had several international exchanges. Our most recent one was with the press in Quito, Ecuador. And that project took us 3 years to complete, but was a wonderful joint exhibition of our printmakers and the printmakers of their studio. We've also exchanged work with the printmakers in Orkney, Scotland, and that was facilitated by Jennifer, who has a home in Scotland. So, that's a little bit about our press. We host the Art Walk as well as the Art Dog Studios. We bring people into the community. We offer works for sale. Everything on the wall is always for sale. And encourage in better times that you will come and you can buy work from the studio, directly from the studio. The COVID is encouraging me to put a store online of our work, and I'm hoping that I'll be able to do that by this fall. So look for us there. This Circling the Square does have an active website, and most of our artists have work that you can see on the website at circlingthesquarepress.com. It's been a fabulous journey and adventure here with the artists, and printmaking being my primary medium, this is where I feel the most warmth and where I feel at home, in this wonderful studio with other printmaking artists, thinking and talking and making multiple originals or one-of-a-kind images. It's great. Thanks.
My name's Rebecca Goodale, and I'm a member here at the Circling the Square Press in Gardiner. I live in Freeport, so it's only about a half-hour drive door-to-door. And in the beginning, I was simply a summertime member, primarily because I like to swim at Jimmy Pond. And then I had two studios going, one in my house, which I loved, and then one downtown in Portland. But more and more, I didn't want to be driving to Portland and paying for parking, so I gave up the Portland studio and did a couple of renovations on my home studio and became a full-time member here. So that's been great. Karen lets me store a lot of my stuff in the basement, which is a bonus. And I probably I'm best known for the artist books I make about Maine's rare plants and animals. However, I do a lot of things that are left and right of that project. I'm often distracted by something just downright beautiful in the natural world. This is a winter fern project that I started last January. It's about a stand of ferns at the Maine Botanical Gardens this winter, where I sat down in the snow and drew them just as black ink on white paper. And then I came back and started to think about what I might do with them in terms of a repeatable pattern. So I printed them first in gray, and then I removed more and I printed it in black. And that is my little square on the quilt, the COVID quilt out there. I just photoshopped this into a square and deleted a lot of the information. Then, I don't know, I'm a Mainer. It was hard for me to just toss this because there's still so much to be cut away. So my plan is to turn this into a summer fern. So I'll be removing more and more until I get the silhouette of a fern in full glory. And it's going to be in outrageous hot colors because of the heat this summer. So that's where I'm taking this, with really no grand goal, but to make three interesting prints, single prints. The first one was conjoined to make a large wallpaper, very dark, but I kind of like this somber attitude. People are nice, but I think like most introverts, I love it when I'm here all by myself, and then I just, all of a sudden, it's not big enough, right? Because you can take over the tables in no time. You can see already today I have. So being alone in here, when that happens, there's no more than two ever at a time, but when you're alone, it's like having Versailles to yourself, and everything's so well organized and super clean, and the other members are great.
Hi, I'm Ellen Roberts, and I'm from Farmington, and I have been with Circling the Square since 2007, and it's been a really incredible experience. It's great working in a community like we have done, and we are able to sign up for a certain amount of time, and then we also can work with others, and we've done a lot of exhibitions, group exhibitions, which is really motivating for our work and encourages everyone to keep pushing forward and experimenting, and there's a lot of learning that goes on here, which is great. And actually, this is a piece that was in a group exhibition here entitled Tête à Tête. It is actually taken from a stone that I repeated. I have a background in textiles, fiber, weaving, and I think my work reflects that when you look at it, because there's a lot of texture and color and repetition that goes on, but there's also a lot of experimentation. So, and that's what I really enjoy. A lot of the time I'll come in here and just start mixing colors and just start working without really knowing how it's gonna end up. I may have a vague idea, but it's really interesting to have the freedom to do that. And I think that Circling a Square invites that kind of experimentation and learning all the time. And that's, I think, what has kept me coming back for the last 13 years.
I'm Judith Long. I live in Brunswick. And I've been making prints since 2008, when I started taking classes with Karen under the Senior Citizen Tuition Waiver Program at UMA, yes. So I like to explore different techniques because I get bored easily. This particular print was during my alewife phase. We went to Damariscotta Mills and saw that whole incredible alewife run in May one year, and I was so impressed with them and the whole community effort to encourage them to come and spawn in Damariscotta Lake and then stay with the babes, and then they and the babies go back to the ocean, and then miraculously 3 years later those babies come as adults and repeat. Anyhow, so this piece, I was experimenting with background textures, first of all, and I work at a food bank, and so I collect stuff that that holds fruit and things like that, and then I press it and I ink it and see what happens. So the background of this was actually one of those thin plastic black things that holds plums and peaches all squashed. And then I cut out a variety of stencils of these alewife shapes and layered them in different shades of purple and an orange, and I moved these guys. First they were orange, and then I put a blue on top and moved the stencil slightly so that we get that shadow color. This is just one of many alewife prints that I made. I made little ones. I've made them on very thin Asian papers because I was also at that time beginning my exploration of working with thin Asian papers like Kozo, Kozo Light, Mulberry, and printing on the back one, two, three different layers, and then after all those layers dry, printing new layers on top. And I have another piece here right now that is called, Red Birches or something like that, in which there are two layers on the back because I'm trying to bring the viewer's eye through the paper and to see what is behind. So I'm trying to get away from a flat, two-dimensional look. And then I use a lot of stencils that I make out of newsprint. And those bring the layers forward. I also do a lot of split fountain work in which I lay out layers of ink, strips of ink, and then roll it and roll it until it blends. This has a split fountain in the background that goes from a deep purple up to a yellow, and then there was other colors layered on top. So basically I like to experiment with papers, with inking techniques, split fountains, and then whatever engages me pretty much in natural world stuff. Like what I'm developing right now is, I hope, a layered work that will have back printing and front printing. But every morning at the breakfast table, I look out at my Italian pole beans, which are on a big high trellis, but I have deer that come and eat all the time, and so I've had to coat cover the front with Tyvek, the insect barrier, to keep the deer from eating it. And when the sun shines on it through that Tyvek, I'm getting many layers of bean leaves and that go from gray greens to bright yellow greens to dark blue greens, and they're all basically shaded by this see-through insect barrier. So I guess that, in a nutshell, is the way I like to explore.
My name is Christine Olson, and I'm a member of Circling the Square Press in Gardiner. And my favorite way to do printmaking, I actually came upon printmaking late in life, in my 50s, before I retired from my job as an environmental scientist. I started taking classes at the University of Maine at Augusta, one class at a time, and went through all the drawing and painting and enjoyed it, and decided to try a printmaking class. And it was love at first sight, and that's all I do now. I love printmaking. My favorite way to do printmaking is reduction prints, like block printing with a piece of linoleum, where you have layers of color that you cut into and then print and continue to print after cutting. So, like, for instance, these are woodpeckers that I did. They're actually socially distancing. This was something that was inspired. They're outside my house, and it was in the spring when we were all just in our yards looking out. And this only has three layers of color. So basically, you go for the lightest layer first, this pale gray. So everything that you would print the linoleum pale gray, then you would carve everything out of the actual linoleum plate that you wanted to print gray, so that the next time you print, which was black, all the areas that were, first of all, you'd have to cut out the white, then you would cut out the gray, and then the last layer would be black. So it's just layering from the lightest to the darkest. And over the years, I've gotten a little more bold, and I've gotten up to 11 layers of color, and I can no longer go light to dark using 11 layers. So I've learned to put an array of colors, and then what sort of colors go on top without interfering too much with the layers below. So I do have a print of some birch trees, also from my yard, which I started out with the yellows and moved in and light grays and moved into the greens. And then on top of everything, I have a light blue.
My name is Caroline Sheridan Luce. I've been a member of Circling the Square Press since, about a year and a half now. And I am a painter and a printmaker, and those two areas really talk to each other while I'm working. When I'm making my prints, I'm really making paintings, and when I'm making my paintings, I'm really thinking about the layering that happens in my printmaking and the marks that I can make on the plate. My pieces are monotypes, which means they are one of a kind. They have been referred to as painterly prints, or a painted print, or a printed painting. And I work with a very large metal plate that is ground for lithography, actually, and holds the ink quite wonderfully. I used to work with plexiglass plates, and I was frustrated by how they didn't hold the ink. And when I first rolled these, there was just this wonderful sensation of how the ink just kind of got sucked up onto the plate and then transferred to the paper. Because I work with layering, these prints are done This has probably gone through the press anywhere from 6 to 10 times. I will put color down, I'll wipe into it, I'll print it, I'll put another color down, wipe into it, print it on top of that, and keep going until the image comes together. I love open space. It is a place that I can breathe and think and enter into in a kind of timeless way. And that's what I look for in my work. I want to create that space in my work that I and hopefully others can enter into in a very meditative way. Until this year, I spent half the year in Nova Scotia, Canada, right on the ocean, and I'm greatly influenced by the fog. I love the fog. And I love watching the light change. Oh, sometimes in the course of a minute or two, there's just land, the seascape after seascape after seascape out there. And I get lost in that. I have enjoyed working large. I have a press in my studio in Canada, but it's not as large as this lovely French tool that we have here. I can work probably about this big, but certainly not the full sheet. And I was so excited when I found Circling the Square Press. One, I couldn't print when we were here in Maine. And I was painting, but really missing the printmaking that I would leave behind when we came back to Maine. And so here I can print. I started working big. I just started these prints when I started coming here. And I love the camaraderie that is in this press. The different people working here with their different points of view and approaches to work, but all with a common goal and a wonderful ability to work together and talk about each other's work. So.
Gardiner, and there's a lot of really cool sculptures here. This one is called Rising by Robert Lash, and what's really cool about it is all these shapes are meant to kind of have you think about the river, the cycles of the river, the fish that jump out of the river, and that's its form. And then you'll see the bottom piece here is like the gears of those mills that were famous along the Kennebec. Very cool.